surrounded by free-minded individuals, people who have different ideas, people of very diverse backgrounds. This is what makes University of Kyrgyzstan very unique in the region.
They are very welcoming, they're open, everyone makes you feel like you're at home.
We are under an umbrella. We all together work together, we all want to improve our ability and to do something for our country.
We have a unifying idea for this institution to achieve academic excellence in order to promote this region. How can you achieve excellence? First of all, through hiring competitive faculty members.
We offer top class and educated individuals from first class institutions around the world.
We are very passionate about what we do. We really want to make a difference in the region.
The instructors are really good at being practical as well as giving you the theory to understand what you need to learn.
They teach you in a way that you never forget them.
We have direct links with industry. So our students are now visiting with partners outside of the university on an almost weekly basis.
Industry needs skilled people. We are producing those skilled people with the help of industry. This link will help UKH to build its future.
University's life is not just about the study. It means that we need social lives.
The UKH has too many clubs. Music club, movie clubs, and sport clubs, everything.
Once our students graduate, they stand out and above others in the region.
I have learned a lot here, and it has added a lot to my knowledge and experience in life. And it gives you a lot of job opportunities after you do graduate from the university.
UKH is the only place that we, as the current generation of this country, can fulfill our dreams.
UKH has given me the confidence and the ability to brighten and shape my future.
This is a place where they can meet their dreams.
Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. University, the University of Kyrgyzstan, Helmand. My name is Heja Sindi, and on behalf of the Canadian Organizing Committee, I would like to announce the start of our today's program. First of all, let me thank my colleagues in the Organizing Committee, Zana, Basman, Niveen, Wuria, for their tremendous work. I would also like to extend my thanks to Amir Anaji, Ahmed Al-Malak, for the tremendous coordination they have shown during the last couple of months. I am indeed very happy to find us all have come to this great day where we gather to celebrate our winners. I would like to start by turning to our winners and quite simply say congratulations. Our program will be started at 10 and conclude at 1 p.m. where we head for lunch. But before that, we have some interviews and networking with the media. I'm sure all of us will experience interesting times throughout the program. And now, please join me in welcoming Khalid Saleh, the Vice Chancellor of UKH, to the stage.
For our university to host this event. We shouldn't be the star. The stars are sitting to your right hand. Congratulations. When we were approached to host this event, one word attracted our attention. It was excellence. We have that in common in terms of providing a space, a so that people can demonstrate their excellency. In whatever area we do, we should be able to gather around performing in an excellent way. We are a new university. We have only 7 years behind us. We can't compare with UK universities. But we have a start which we are proud of right now. And we would like to make this excellence as a trademark of our activities. So whenever you have something excellent to share, please come to us. And I hope you all the best during the day and for the rest of your achievements. Thank you very much for coming to University of Kurdistan Erbil.
Chancellor, award winners, esteemed guests and sponsors of the Tamiyuz Awards. It is with great pride and honour that I am able to be here representing Coventry University, who are the academic sponsor of the Tamiyuz Awards. 2 years ago, I was in a coffee shop in Coventry with Ahmed Al-Malik. He had recently joined my department as a lecturer in design, and he wanted to talk to me about his idea and desire to promote excellence in architecture and design and bring the talent in Iraqi schools of architecture to the world's attention. At the time, it seemed like a very laudable but very ambitious project. But here we are now at the second Tamiyuz Awards, and may there be many more. Supported by a select group of sponsors and judges who share the vision of the Tamiyuz team, his vision and aspiration to showcase Iraqi architects and architecture to the world. So why did Coventry University want to support Tamiyuz as an academic sponsor? Well, Ahmed can be very persuasive. His energy and drive is infectious. You just have to ask the students that he teaches back in Coventry. But it really is because we share the Tamiyuz vision. Most of you have probably never heard of Coventry or Coventry University. So let me tell you a little bit of our history and our future. Coventry University is the 12th largest university in the UK, with more than 30,000 students. 5,000 of those are international, the largest population of international students on any UK university campus. Many of our international students come from parts of the world that have been ravaged by war. Indeed, Coventry itself was destroyed in 1940. The city rebuilt itself and has become home to an eclectic mix of architectural styles, some very successful, some that were not. And what of the people? Well, like me, many of them are proud to live in the city known for embracing peace and reconciliation. Coventry University is currently 5 years into a £160 million project to regenerate the city centre through architecture. The two projects completed so far, the hub, a new building for students, and the engineering and computing building, my own faculty's building, which you saw on the video, have both won prizes from the Royal Institute of British Architects. In 2011, we were named as the most entrepreneurial university in the UK for our support of local technology business, again rejuvenating the city of Coventry and its people and its economy. In 2013, we were given the Athena Swan Bronze Award for our efforts in promoting careers in science, technology, engineering and mathematics to women in the UK. This year, we were named the best modern university in the UK, in the top 15 for the quality of our teaching, and for the first time ever, Coventry University is in the list of the top 400 universities in the world. So we are a university with drive and ambition, and we are on a mission to give our graduates the best education, the best start to their careers, and a global perspective of their future role in the world. We give all of our students the opportunity to have an international experience as part of their course. This ranges from being a member of our Global Leaders Programme, with networks across the globe, or through a period of study or work overseas, or in joint projects with students from our partner universities. I'm extremely pleased to be able to announce that Coventry University has now become a financial and economic sponsor of the Tammy Hughes Awards. We share a common vision and aspiration to promote and reward excellence in architecture because of its ability to invigorate our environment, enhance our communities, and improve our lives. I congratulate the winners of the Tammy Hughes Awards and hope that their success will lead them to even greater achievements, but not only for themselves, but for the people whose lives they improve through their creativity, their passion, and their inspiration. Thank you.
And now I'd like to introduce you to Ahmed Al-Malak, the founder of Tammy's Award.
Mr. Vice Chancellor, award winners, esteemed guests, friends and family, welcome to the second annual Tammy's Excellence Awards from the beautiful city of Belleville. Before I start, I would like to take this opportunity to thank the University of Kurdistan. Mr. Vice Chancellor, thank you for hosting us. You have been a great host for us. And I would like to point out two things. The first thing is the university and yourself are setting an example, a very important example, on how academic institutions can play a vital role in developing social life and the community. And the second thing, you're introducing and promoting a very important idea, which is corporate social responsibility. And that's one of the reasons we're here. So thank you very much for that. Now, before I start with the ceremony and the award giving and introducing you to our panel, I'll just talk about a few things about Tammy Hughes, if you don't know what is Tammy Hughes. Tammy Hughes Excellence Award is a social enterprise. We aim to develop the community. Its aim is to advance the profession of architecture academically and professionally by the help of our sponsors, our judges, and the winners. They put us back on the map. The objectives of Ateneos. They are recognizing excellence and rewarding it wherever it exists. The second one is empowering women, drawing women architects in a field where it's mainly male dominated. The third one is advancing architectural education, and we have been successful until now, and I hope we can continue. The fourth thing, which is my surprise for you all today, is we celebrate and recognize architects, the pioneers of Iraqi and regional architecture, Middle Eastern architecture, and we will celebrate them. And today, we will celebrate one of them. Before I introduce you to the panel, I would like to introduce you to the categories of our awards for this year. In 2012, we started with one category, which is in red. It was for students studying in 11 Iraqi universities, all the cities. Then the year after, we made it for all Iraqis all over the world. We have submissions from Syria, Lebanon, Denmark, Sweden. Everyone is competing. Everyone wants to be recognized. And we're happy. We have 11 from the local universities and just one from abroad. So we are actually doing well. The second category, which is established in 2013, is for me the most important. It's women in architecture. Women in construction and architecture. This award is special for two things. The first thing is, today we are celebrating here in Erbil, before Paris. In the world, there are three awards for women. Last year, the first was in England, the second is here in Erbil, and later this year, they will celebrate it in Paris. So we are ahead. We are ahead in empowering women and celebrating their achievements. And I hope we can continue and do that. And if we get all the support we can do, maybe we can make it for the whole Middle East, because we are the pioneers of architecture. Third one is established this year. It's lifetime achievements. We have so many great architects who no one celebrates anymore. They have done so much. Most of us studied, learned from them. And today we're going to celebrate one of them. Two more. A new category, which the aim of it is to make Ateneos and architecture mainstream. We want the media to talk about architecture. It has been neglected. So the last category is open for everyone. Everyone who is doing something that promotes architecture, something that brings architecture on the map, someone who have helped us conserve some of our treasures, our heritage. So it's open for anyone, journalists, urban designers, architects, educators, and I hope we will have some great entries. The last one is the first of its kind in the world. It's an award for students in British universities. But the thing is, we judge it. Academics from all universities judge it. Last year, we have here with us Dr. Ramah Malaika. She's one of the judges of this award. And again, this year, plus many others. These are the categories that we will celebrate next year, hopefully. Here, Mr. Vice Chancellor. The second thing that I would like to talk about is a program that we have developed with Statistics Department. It is the first of its kind independent ranking for universities based on achievements and awards. If you have a look, you can see in orange, that was the number of participants in 2012, and we had 135 students. This year, a few universities woke up, and we have almost 100 more students. And for 2014, we already exceeded this, but the registration is not over. Now, I'll show you what happened in 2012. these are the scores of their universities. The universities who achieved the best. The top three were the University of Technology in Baghdad, then the University of Duhok, and then the University of Basra. The top three. 2013, there was a very tough competition between two universities, the University of Technology and University of Salahuddin. We have three winners in the top 10, three from University of Technology, three from Salahuddin, but minus score difference. The overall for the last 2 years, as you can see, is we have technology as the best achieving in some years. Then we have the University of Duhok as the second best. We always have one in the top three from Duhok. Then we have Salahuddin and Basra and Baghdad, fifth place. So I hope this gives you an insight of the feedback that we put into what's going on in the awards. This program, we hope to develop it further, and maybe we can have a ranking, a proper ranking, independent ranking for the universities here. This will help us get accreditation. If we want our students to go abroad, study, they want to go abroad and work, they can go back and look, are they doing well? Yes. They can work, they can study. So that's the main aim of this. I don't want to take further and bore you with some of my statistics. I will start to introduce you to my panel. They are the backbone of this award. Of course, the humbleness of Dr. Khalid, he didn't want to be on the panel, our host. By the way, let me tell you something. It's really interesting and it will cost me a lot of money today. We have a deal between me and Dr. Khalid. In this university, you cannot say the title of the person. If you say doctor, if you say mister, you have to pay 5,000 dinars, and this goes for charity. So you can count how much I'm paying today. Okay. I would like to start and introduce you to our first sponsor. His name is Mr. Excellence, I can call him like that easily. He has been setting the rules of the game of architecture in the Middle East for more than a decade. Wherever you go, wherever you see his projects, it's excellence. Excellence of design. He's also very generous. We, as Tamayus, and their firm, I will not mention it now, have a program. The winners of Tamayus go to Dubai and they practice under their supervision for 2 months, paying their salaries, paying their accommodation. And I'm very grateful for him. I would like to introduce you to our first speaker, Mr. Mohammed Al-Assan, the chairman of the D1 Group.
Thank you for the nice compliments I got from Ahmed. Thank you very much. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So I'm so delighted really to be here this morning, seeing this presence and the award itself and this celebration. And this really makes me believe more than ever that there is a light at the end of the tunnel. And as I put a line under it, there is a light at the end of the tunnel. So this is very promising for our future. My name is Mohammed Al-Assan, Mohammed Al-Assan, and I'm founder and chairman of D1 Architects. D1 Architects has been about 32 years in the same name, about 40 years old practice, and it has 10 offices in the region, and I think around 330 or slightly more than that staff, all over the places. And we are the leading regional firm, I would say, for the proud and humbleness as well. And D1 has been for the 6 years in a row on the top 100 Architectural Firms list issued by Building Design Magazine in the UK. And on the top 225 architectural engineering firms published by McGraw-Hill in the States. And our activities, our specialties, planning, urban planning and design, architecture in many fields, especially in the hospitality and the mixed-use complexes. The one philosophy and vision is the top one is the quality driven. Since we started maintaining the quality and serving the profession was always on the top of our concerns. We have hundreds of projects. I cannot say that all of them are a success, but many of them, at least most of them, are success stories. And we have offices, as I said, in about 10 offices all over the region, with 3 offices in Iraq, and our plan is to open an office in Kurdistan this year. We are well known as a green firm. We take great attention to sustainability. And in fact, we are the first firm to get one per rating in the UAE for sustainability, and we are the first firm to get a 3-star rating in sustainability in the Emirates. Something very important in our office, in our life, is the feeling, the family feeling inside the firm. We all like one big family. There's a lot of social work. There's a lot, even marriages happen in the office. So we are very proud of that as well. We have our own football club and cycling club as well. And we are proud, of course, to be a part of this Tamayuz Award. That's a privilege to us ladies, and we are honored to be a part of it. And sharing and supporting the talented architect, talented young architects is one of our goals. We do it all the time, not only through the Tamayuz Award. We always have like 4 or 5 people trained in the office, either the students of architecture or the fresh graduates. The last one is a small word that this country, our Iraq, our home, has given us so much, really, and it is by sponsoring young architects, young Iraqi architects, we are just paying just a little of our debts to this society. So we are not doing a favor to anybody. What Ahmed said about lifetime achievements, just to let you know that we are co-organizers in Dion, we are co-organizers through our office in Baghdad in celebration of 100 years of Dr. Makiya. He's 100, Dr. Mohammed Makiya is 100 years old this year. And we are making, not the week, coming week, the week after, we are making a celebration in Baghdad, sponsored by Amanat Baghdad. And the idea really is by Dr. Khalid Sultan, many of you, or most of you know. So you are all invited. If you want to attend, by all means, we welcome you in Baghdad. That's all. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Muhammad. I would like to introduce you to an architect, an excellent architect in London. Wherever you go, high-end market, his name is there. That is not the reason why he's talking to us. The reason is he was the first judge to join the panel. I didn't even have to try and convince him. I said, we have an award for promoting Exodus. He said, I'm in. After that, he said, it's not enough to judge it only. I will sponsor it. We'd like to introduce you to the owner of Erda Tuhafi Architects, Mr. Erda Tuhafi.
Thank you, Ahmed, for the introduction. On behalf of the judges, I would like to
extend my sincere thanks and gratitude to all those who made this event possible. When I was approached by Ahmed, it's almost 3 years ago, I already had my doubts that this can be managed from abroad and how difficult it will be. But after the first meeting, I saw his vision, his commitment, what he had in mind, how big he wants this to be. I just couldn't really resist to say yes, I would like to be part of it and see that it can happen. And here we are today, we are all sitting celebrating this vision and commitment. Of course, I was honored to know that I was the first person approached to be the judge. I know how everybody worked so hard to come to this point. As judges, we know how important it is to be impartial. So when I agreed to come in and be a judge, I mean, the first thing was discussed. I wanted to ensure that we will never know the name of any students of any university, and we really want to judge them on their excellence of work. And that was the case the last 2 years. We always got the material and we didn't know who we are judging, just the material itself. For the students, we know, our future architects, we know how hard you worked. And you, who matters, I must say it was very difficult. After knowing the amount of hours and your work, your supervisors, to judge you on two sheets of paper. It was with variety of a project, variety of styles. But at the end, we did our best, and I think we almost, in the 2 years, we agreed, and we are proud to see the result. And on my personal basis, I would like to thank you all. I've been absent from Iraq for 27 years. So today is the opportunity for me to come back and feel at home. So thank you all, and all the success.
Our next speaker is coming all the way from London. She has worked in all difficult conditions, developing communities. She worked in South America, in Africa, and in Europe, working and providing grassroots solutions to struggling communities. Please welcome with me Catherine McNeill, the Director of Architecture for Humanity, London.
Internationally, in areas which include poverty alleviation, providing access to safe water, sanitation, and power. Inclusive design and architectural services for community buildings and public spaces. Rebuilding community through shared dialogues and addressing climate change. The organisation was founded by Cameron Sinclair and Kate Storr in 1999. We now reach out to more than 10,000 people each year. Our volunteers are diverse thinking people with backgrounds as architects and designers. We collaborate with craftspeople, textiles designers, makers and photographers. The key to our work is listening and hearing our clients. Through the processes of participation, we create a shared dialogue of exchange, forging relationships to solve the complex challenges of today. And we view these dialogues as an opportunity to gather and harvest the creative ideas of the community together. These communities are often the quiet voices who go unheard, people with enormous capacity and social assets. For example, a deep knowledge of traditional building practices and making, detailed understanding of natural water supplies, an embedded generational knowledge of plants and animals. These communities remind us how to regain our sense of being human through architecture, and involving high-level governmental thinking and other actors helps to bridge the gaps in scale between the micro and the super macro implementation. We work as a network of over 50 chapters, which span from London, my home chapter, to Bogota, San Francisco, or HQ as we know it in our network, to Tokyo, and New York to Haiti. The Bogota chapter is speaking at the World Urban Forum in Medellin in April as a result of our connections in London. Chapters exchange knowledge and experiences too. Small steps for now, but we like to think small is beautiful. Our ability to respond in this way, we think, is unique. When Ahmed Al-Malik first told me about the Tamayo's Award, we recognised the opportunity for young Iraqi architecture students to have a shared focus in architectural achievement and excellence, and to collectively showcase their work to an international audience. This engagement is creating and building a space of cultural exchange and dialogue so vital to the discovery of living, learning, working and playing together in the 21st century. Judging the award has and is an interesting experience. One of the many aspects I enjoy is the thought of this review being carried out across the world. Gathering last night for Chi, there was a sense of joy of people coming together. The conversations were simply inspiring. The Tamayo's for us at Architecture for Humanity represents a place of gathering, exchange and ideas. This kind of open place parallels the way in which we at Architecture for Humanity work. The range of ideas within the work presented for the award is exciting. The projects are ambitious, sophisticated and beautifully presented. There are many themes evident: connectivity, culture, environment, and the investigation of context, a core aspect within our work. I commend the students' professors for their inspired teaching, clearly evident in the work. And most importantly, to the students and all the award recipients, many congratulations. Thank you.
Important sponsor, an important backer for this award. He unfortunately couldn't make it, but his program is really important. It's a private foundation. It's an academic foundation. It's called Majid Al-Saadi Scholarship Foundation. It's one of the leading in the Middle East for the last 6 years. They've been giving 10 scholarships a year for students from all over the Middle East to come and study in Coventry University. And he was kind enough to give us some of those scholarships. He also runs the life-changing program where they take 14 students from the UK and they bring them to the Middle East and they try and make them understand us better, promote our culture. I'm so happy that we have a partnership with them, and this partnership will continue. Fortunately, he's not here. Our next speaker is the person that, when things go wrong, I call her. things don't work, say, can you please see if we can do it in Jordan, Erbil, London. My plan B, when I can't do it, my last call. She's the only specialist, let me say, in corporate social responsibility. She actually understands what is it. Please welcome with me, Dr. Ahmed Anaji.
On behalf of the Tamiz team, I would like to thank the winners, judges, academic institutions, Coventry University, University of Kurdistan, Hawler, companies and business organizations, United Nations Global Compact, and United Nations Development Program. Tamiz Award appreciates your effort toward creating a cross-national, cross-sector network, assuming social responsibility as part of your total responsibility to the welfare of our societies. Thank you from the bottom of our hearts. Thank you.
And now our last speaker. When we started asking for, well, the first day that we sent an email inquiring, is anyone interested in sponsoring? Because I live abroad, I said it's going to be too much work, it's going to be impossible. And I was planning to work really hard for it. I sent that email. 3 minutes after, we received an answer. He said, yes, I'll sponsor. And the amount you are asking for is not enough. I will double it for you. He's very generous. He's the chairman of the United Nations Global Compact. And he is the owner and the chairman of Adulaini Group. Please welcome with me, Mr. Mohammed Adulaini.
Good morning. I want to start from the speech of Mr. Ahmed and say, my surprise that Dr. Ahmed, member of United Nations Global Compact, arrived. And she is responsible on CSR, corporate social responsibility. Send this email for to us, all of the group. And as he said, my feedback coming just within 3 minutes. But my big surprise after 1 year of work, for the last award in the end, and after the ceremony of the award, my surprise that Ahmed, the son of Dr. Ahmed, please. And maybe excuse me to speak in Arabic for this area because it's regard feeling, and maybe because English is not my daily language. Okay, I'm explaining English, no problem. Why my feedback is just in the interference? Because when I was, before 30 years ago, we are together with my friend, my best friend, Bilal. We studied together, and his dream was to build something like hanging gardens in Babylon or something like that. But we lose Niral and his dream and the war. So I promised myself, and I promised the soul of Niral, that I will continue to support indigenous people to build Iraq. And I'm thinking, how many genius people Iraqi, we lose them every day on this world. So that's why my feedback is coming in the team. Sorry. Thank you, Ahmed, for this opportunity. to speak a little bit about the UNGC, or United Nations Global Compact, Iraq. Our major challenge is to let the private sector achieve the 10 principles which depend on anti-corruption, sustainability, environment friendly, labor's life, human rights, the 10 principles of the United Nations for the private sector. But the major challenge is to let them achieve to the CSR, to take their responsibility for the people, for the where they're working. And this is our main goal. I was very happy that the first award of Tameyus supported by companies from the United Nations Global Compact Iraq. They start from the top. Mr. Hassan told me that I said, we miss you in our network. He said, yes, I'm a member, but I'm lazy. I said, no, that you start from the top, from the CSR. You support this Tameyus award. So we trust that is you start for the top of the principles. The UNGC or United Nations Global Compact started in 2011 with the initiative between the government and UNDP and the private sector. By the way, we are here today to celebrate this important event, and the board of United Nation Global Compact, they are with me, and allow me please to introduce them. Dr. Amila, responsible on CSR on our Global Compact. Mr. Mann, United Nations, the Development Program in Iraq. Hadid, member of the board. Abbas, member of the board. Salah, member of the board. Muhammad, member of the board. And I take this opportunity to invite you all here to be a member of the United Nations Global Compact Iraq. Thank you so much.
Start the ceremony. Tameyus Excellence Award has 235 participants last year. The biggest award in the Middle East, which is based in Jordan, they were celebrating after 10 years. They had more than 100 students. So we are much ahead. And that's not because of me, not because of the sponsors. It's because of one team that works really hard. Tameyus has a team in every single university. And we are really proud that they managed in 2 years to make us the biggest award in terms of participants. So what I would like to do is to ask Mr. Mohammed Abdullahi, the chair of the UNGC, to give them certificates of appreciation. Please, Mr. Mohammed. Okay, so we will start with the University of Sulaymaniyah. Mr. Omid Jumasidir, please welcome. University of Koya, this is Shaymar Kubaisi. From Al Nahrain University, Mrs. Rasha Abdul Karim. University of the Hawk, Mrs. Juan Khoshi.
University of Babylon, Mr. Hussam Jabbar. University of Babylon is not here today. Okay. University of Baghdad, Mr. Hisham Ala.
For me, the Tamiz Award is about recognising educational excellence in Iraq. It's a rare opportunity to bring together projects and hard work of architectural students from 9 different universities across the country. And it's an opportunity for them students to show the world really what they can do. Additionally, the award brings a wide range of organisations from the construction industry, such as Zaha Hadid Architects, the Royal Institute of British Architects, Coventry University, and Construction Limited, Structural Engineering, in a non-political way, without a fire agenda, all for the benefit of the students.
La red de, creada por el Premio de Excelencia de Tamayuz está en continua evolución y crecimiento desde su fundación el año pasado. Esto es lo que hace que se estén abriendo constantemente nuevas avenidas y nuevas posibilidades de colaboración. Pero si tuviéramos que resumir en una diapositiva los puntos más importantes, el alcance geográfico, humano, de sectores, lingüístico, de la red, estos serían los puntos que destacaríamos. Estamos hablando de una colaboración de más de 50 personas en 8 países diferentes que están repartidos por 3 continentes. En la red se hablan más de 11 lenguas diferentes y las principales son inglés, árabe y kurdo. Estas personas colaborando en la red de Tamayud lo hacen en diferentes áreas en el premio. Pueden estar en calidad de patrocinadores, de jueces, de diferentes asesores o de representantes de las universidades y la CIE. Por otro lado, en la red vemos la participación de diferentes sectores, por supuesto, arquitectura y construcción, pero también ingenierías de diferentes tipos, obras públicas o de estructuras, responsabilidad social corporativa, investigación en las diferentes áreas y también relaciones internacionales. También una mención importante dentro de esta red internacional a la diversidad de patrocinadores y la importancia y relevancia que tienen, porque podemos encontrar a empresas privadas y públicas que están apoyando el premio, pero también organizaciones internacionales a nivel mundial y a nivel nacional. Por otro lado, la red del Premio de Excelencia de Tamayud es muy importante y tiene, yo creo que representaría uno de los factores por el que el premio está evolucionando y está creciendo como lo está haciendo, porque toda esta red de profesionales y expertos que se ha creado está favoreciendo su crecimiento y evolución.
أزعم أن جائزة تميز العمارة التي أسسها الصديق والزميل أحمد الملاك ودأب على ترسيخها في مشهد المعمار المحلي لها أهمية خاصة لجهة كونها تثير الانتباه إلى إبداع فني ومهني رفيعين وهو الإبداع المعماري الذي ظل مع الأسف الشديد إبداعا منسيا لا يهتم به أحد رغم أن العمارة والعمران هما اللذان يحددا سمات وطبيعة مدننا ونوعية مسكننا وخاصية أمكنة عملنا وراحتنا وكل ما يتعلق بالنشاط الإنساني المتنوع والمتعدد. كما أن حضور هذه الجائزة وظهورها اللافت يعمل كحافز معنوي للكثير من المعماريين الممارسين العراقيين وكذلك يدفع بطلبة العمارة نحو التميز ويحثهم للوصول إلى إبداع مهني حقيقي.
Mr. Ayada Tuhati and Ms. Catherine McNeil to hand the prizes, please. In the ninth place,
private international university in Syria, Mr. Ahmed Maher Rashid. Eighth place, Hassan Saleh Kakama from the University of Salahuddin.
Contribution in a specific sector goes to
Suspetuh as a way for the healthcare facility sector. Mr. Mohammed Al Hassan, please. Stand up, right.
Thank you, Mr. Ahmed. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I'd like to thank Tamayus Team Award and the sponsors and the judges for their great efforts and their support to us. I'd like also to thank His Excellency Minister of Health to attend this ceremony. As an architect working in the Ministry of Health since 25 years, I am so so proud and feel so happy because I support because I make a support to our people who is in urgent need to our support to so many projects I have been working on during this period. And I'd like to remind our colleagues, our architects, that our country is in urgent need to your support. So please be optimistic in life. Even everything is going wrong, please always be focused on your goals and you will see that life is smiling in your favor. Last and not least, I'd like to dedicate this one to His Excellency Minister of Health for his great support to me. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Chitov. Sorry, Mr. Lassam. You're giving all the prizes for the honorable mentions. Yes, yeah, sorry. Okay, so the next person.
You have to pay me 5,000 because it's your Mr.
Oh, yeah, I know. We'll see how much I have to pay at the end of the ceremony. Okay, the next person who is receiving another honourable mention for an outstanding contribution. She's a hard-working architect. She has worked a lot in project planning and management. She's a role model for women managing large-scale projects. Very serious in her work. Please welcome with me for her outstanding contribution in professional practice and management, Mrs. Huda Mohammed Ali.
Women, I'd like to thank Mr. Ahmed, all the sponsors and the juries, and my old teachers, especially Mrs. Janet, and I'd like to thank my family, especially the great woman in my life, my mother, and thank you all, and thank you for this. Thank you.
Oh, God. Yeah. years and has inspired many students with her hard work and her interest in her field. She has organized events around the world, introducing our local architecture, introducing us to the world. Please welcome with me, for her outstanding contribution in architectural education, Dr. Adelson.
Architecture into private practice. And I think that's where we as women architects to re-add value for real projects and make a difference to our homes, our schools, our hospitals, our built environment, our landscape, whatever it is, our viewpoint, our inspiration, our ideas needs to be out there along with our male counterparts, because together, hey, we make the best architecture. May I say congratulations on your first Tamaise Award. It's an absolute wonderful thing to win Excellence Award for Women in Architecture. Paris is in fact doing one next month. In Britain, the Architects Journal, one of our leading journals, did one last year and again this year. So we are all thinking about the same thing at the same time. It is absolutely brilliant for women in architecture and how to get more women into architecture by inspiring the youth of today.
المجتمع الكوري كما بحاجة المجتمعات العربية وخصوصا في العراق ضمن ظهور جائزة تميز خاصة بالمعماريات العراقية له حدث راح على جانب كثير من الروعة والضرورة أيضا وأعترف بأن غبطة كبيرة وسرور طاغم أحسست بهما عندما ساهمت في تحكيم أعمال زميلات العزيزات المعماريات العراقيات المبدعات هنا اللاتي قدمنا أعمال تصميمية مميزة ولافتة وهدف الجائزة يكمن بالأساس في حث وتشجيع المعماريات نحو التميز في العمل التصميمي والجائزة تحرص في هذا المجال إلى ترسيخ قيم احترام المرأة العاملة والمبدعة وتسهم أيضا في تكريس وتأكيد نجاحاتها في عملها الإبداعي.
Why is the prize for women into architecture so important? Well, it's possible to suggest it is because we need the equality of opportunity for women to practice in architecture. But I would tend to put it the other way around. It's more important to say that architecture needs women. Architecture as a discipline needs the perspective that women bring. It needs their passion, their enthusiasm, their ability to see problems from a different perspective. And without that, we have half architecture. We don't have the complete picture. And so I wouldn't pose the question that says women need architecture. I think the real question, the real exam question for all of us, is architecture needs women. We've had 19 contributions from women architects towards this prize. All of them have been outstanding, and all quite remarkable when you think about the circumstances in which the contributions were engineered and designed and the concepts that went into them. A very hostile environment sometimes, personally and professionally, and yet despite that, these 19 women have battled through and made some fantastic contributions to the prize. It's interesting to try and pull out some of the special features of what is in a woman's approach to architecture. And I think one of the things that I'm picking up on is the ability to work outside of one's comfort zone, to challenge and to go into different areas, different cultures, and learn from those cultures, but then to bring it back and have the desire to pass that knowledge on. Men can do it, of course. But I think there's a particular talent that women have in order to assimilate other people's ideas, to interpret them, and to pass them on to others. That's a unique feature that I'm seeing in all the contributions from the women architects. It's a first-class skill, a very rare skill, and again, something that architecture needs around the world.
Now we move to... Oh, sorry.
Now we move to a very important category. We have design excellence by students, but can we achieve that without our academics, our hard-working academics? Today we have two honorable mentions and the Supervisor of the Year, which we started last year. Last year the Supervisor of the Year was from the University of Dubok, Dr. Amaha Al-Malaika, and she's again with us as an honorable mention. Before that, I would like to call Mr. Finn Davis, Dr. Shadina Coventry and Dr. Ahmed Naji, to give the prizes. The second honourable mention goes to Dr. Amhan Malaika from the University of Cork.
Sponsoring team for the Tenayus Award for this actually outstanding event, which is very unique in our country, and now it's starting to be all for all universities and for the students. Actually, they are universities. Well, I would like to thank actually University of Duhok in Kurdistan region. For me especially, I've spent actually my whole life in Baghdad. But since maybe 3 years, it was an opportunity for me to come to Duhok University. And maybe it is meant to be so that I will be awarded in Kurdistan region in Duhok University. Thank you all, and thanks again.
The next honorable mention is the supervisor of the winning project. Please welcome with me from the University of Technology in Baghdad, Dr. Ismail Mutarov.
Our students in my department to do their best to increase their efforts, and their goal is to win one of your prizes. So many thanks to support Iraqi African students. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Before we announce the supervisor of the year, it's going to be a video. Mr. Vice Chancellor, we're going to give this prize, but after the video.
Every outstanding student knows an outstanding supervisor. And this needs to be recognised across the piece. But this year, one supervisor stood out from all the others. This individual supervised 3 out of the top 10 projects that we saw. A remarkable contribution. So it's a pleasure for me to announce that the 2013 Supervisor of the Year goes to Dr. Hamed Turki from the University of Salahuddin. An amazing contribution, sir, that you've done to bring these young people forward and to give them your support and your guidance to make the outstanding contributions that they have. My warmest congratulations to you. I'd like to extend it further also, if you would do me the privilege of joining me as a visiting research fellow at my faculty in the UK. I'll be delighted to welcome you here.
Now, the supervisor of the year, as you can see, has been offered a fellowship to come and do research in Coventry University for 2 years. So, Mr. Vice-Chancellor, are you happy to give that answer?
I will think about it.
Okay. Please welcome with me from the University of Salahuddin, Dr. Hamed Turki. Thank you, Mr. Vice-Chancellor.
It's my pleasure to stand here today. I would like to thank Tamayiz Award, who is working hard to support the architectural field in Iraq. Tamayiz Award is adding a big change in enthusiasm among students and teachers. I hope that this will encourage others to follow. Many, many thanks to Tamayiz Award, its sponsors, its judges. I want to thank also the University of Coventry for the generous invitation. I want to thank also Professor Paul Ivey, whose warm words touched my heart and brought me to tears. Thanks to Salahuddin University, who deserves the best of our efforts. Thanks to my colleagues in my department, who are sharing with me this honor. Thanks to Kurdistan, the land of peace and tolerance. Thanks to my family, who's stood on my side, thanks to my father, who is now 100 years old, and he is telling me on daily basis that the loyalty war is a part of God's belief, or belief in God. Thanks to my students, Sarah, Hassan, and Ibrahim, for their hard work, for their patience and passion. I wish them a bright future. But on this occasion, I have to say what I offer them is nothing more than my belief in their ability, because I believe that the young has or have a powerful and creative minds to do the impossible. So let's go together to the future. Thank you very much.
Three projects were described as outstanding by international architects, international academics, and local architects. To give that prize for the winners, I would like to ask Mr. Mohammed Al-Dulaimi to give a prize. Mr. Tim Davis to give the certificate. Mr. Mohammed Al Asad to do the training. The training. Please welcome with me the third place from the University of York, Diana Dawood.
My family, especially my parents, for their support. And this award is dedicated to them and to my university, University of Duhok, to my supervising team. And I'm honored that now I'm part of the staff of the University of Duhok to give back even just a portion of what I have received from you. So, and finally, a special thanks goes to the founder of this award. You have no idea what this means to us, so thank you and God bless you. Thank you.
I would like to thank God for his never-ending grace during what ended up being one of the biggest achievements in my life. To be considered for this award is an immense honor and a pleasure, so I would like to thank El Tamayus, the judges, and all those who have been supporting this great organization. Next, I would like to thank my brilliant and outstanding supervisor, Dr. Asma Muhammad, whose leadership and vision steered the project since the day we started. Last and of course not least, to my astounding supporting family and those who have touched me since I started all this, there would be no grace without any of you. Thank you so much for everything.
Three more prizes left. This one is important because we recognize excellence across universities. This prize is new. Last year, there was a winner, but we didn't give them a prize. But again, they won it again this year. So I think we'll do it like football. You win it a third time, you can keep the trophy. Please, welcome with me the Best Architectural Department, 2013, University of Technology. Mr. Davis, would you like to have the trophy?
Nominated by our Dean, Dr. Ibrahim Jouad, to receive such a prize. And third, because I've been for 20 years a member of staff, working and teaching and living, love and share a lot with my students. I have now, in my ID, I have three sons, but actually I have more 300. They are all my sons. And here I have Dr. Salah, I have Dr. Hussein, I have Sid Shema, and I have a lot of doctors in philosophy and of architecture. They are tutoring in our beloved Iraq for architecture. We are in the University of Technology, always committed to excellency. And that's why we are running 2 years in a row for ranking the first prize. I would like to thank Mr. Ahmed Al-Malak for sparing no time and effort to manage this celebration. Also, the sponsors of TAMEUS and also all the students that participated in this ceremony. Actually, this will lead us to one conclusion, that we as an Iraqis are still and will always be able to overcome all the difficulties, able to give and to share and to participate and to compete in all disciplines. Thank you again, and I hope we will get the, what you call it in football, the hat trick next year. Thank you very much.
Just for now. Thank you very much.
The next award is for the overall winner of the women category. Mr. Vice Chancellor, Dr. Al-Qadi will be handing the prize. The winner is an architect. An academic who specialized in landscape design. She taught architecture and landscape at the University of Technology in Baghdad for 15 years. In 2001, she founded landscape department at the American University in Beirut. In 2007, she co-founded the Cambridge Center for Landscape and People in Cambridge. She also worked as a consultant in architecture and landscape in Iraq, Syria, UAE, Lebanon, and Cyprus. She's a remarkable academic, activist in the field of landscape design. She taught many architects who are here with us, and they consider her a role model. It gives me great pleasure to announce the winner of the first ever TAMEUS Women in Architecture and Construction Award, and the second ceremony in the world, in Erbil, celebrating women, Dr. Rajal Makhzoomi. Mr. Vice Chancellor.
Inshallah, we'll come home. It is a fantastic journey to be daughter to one of the most, or the best Kurdish historians, and come back and receive, or granddaughter, I think you are. She's granddaughter of Muhammad Zaki, the founding father of Kurdish historiography. It's a great privilege to have you at our university.
وأود أن أشير بأن هذه الجائزة هي جائزة سنوية سيختار منظمو الجائزة شخصية معمارية وستكرم أثناء منح جائزة التميز المعماري، وبالطبع ستكون المساهمة الفعالة في إنجاز العمارة العراقية وفي تحقيق منجز العمارة العراقية. والأعمال الشخصية لهذا المعمار هي الحكم والمعيار لاختيار هذه الشخصية لهذه الجائزة.
The surprise is, gives me great pleasure to announce in front of you that the recipients of the inaugural Tamayyuz Lifetime Achievement Award in Architecture is the founder of Baghdad School of Architecture, who turns 100 this year. Unfortunately, he's unable to be with us. The recipient is Dr. Muhammad Saleh Makia.
We'd like to take this opportunity to thank the supporters of the Tamayyuz Award. in particular the judges, the sponsors and the rest of the support team in Iraq. But most importantly, we'd like to thank the students. This is your award, and each and every one of you has done yourselves proud by producing some fantastic projects and setting a real benchmark for future final-year architectural projects in Iraq. From everyone at the Tamayuz Award, we're all looking forward to another successful year in 2014.
Thank you very much to the Tamayuz team for recognising the important role that women have in architecture and construction. The future is bright. Congratulations.
With this ceremony, I would like to take a few minutes to thank a few people. I'd like to thank Mr. Tim Davis for everything. You're the first person I've talked to about this award, and we're here today. Kathleen, thank you very much. It's a pleasure to work with you and teach with you. Mr. Ayad, thank you very much for giving me the first job in London, and thank you for being the first judge on the award and a sponsor of the award. Mr. Mohammed Drain, you made my life much easier. Thank you very much for your prompt response and continuous support of this award. So Mohammed Al-Hassan, thank you very much for the opportunity that you are giving us to have students practice in your firm that is excellence itself. Dr. Amir Naji, if I may call you mother, thank you very much for everything. I would like also to thank Mr. Kamran Khadari for helping us to be here in Arbat. Mr. Johar, thank you very much. I really appreciate it. I appreciate all the help you gave us. And finally, can you before that just tell them how much I have to pay by the end of this day? Mr. Vice Chancellor, thank you very much for having us. You have been a great host. All of you, thank you for keeping up with me, smiling all the way. Can we please give a round of applause for everyone here? Now to conclude this ceremony, I will invite Nowruz. She will introduce a band. We will have live music. Okay?
Would you like to introduce the band?
We will have UK Edge Band. They will have the performance, but they don't need to prepare the stage before that. So.
Thank you.
Thank you. they'll perform a song by Karwan Kamel, Ewaraya.
Thank you very much, and we hope that you had an excellent day with us here.